smoking dope. I'm talking dope. I smoking dope and smoking. I'm talking dope. I smoking dope. I talking smoking talking. I smoking dope. I'm talking dope. I smoking talking smoking. I'm talking dope. You should have been there. She really got it. You should have been there. No one could stop it. Kylie's gonna get you smoking dope with black boys in the girls' bathroom. Kylie, whoa, Kylie. Kylie's gonna get you smoking dope with black boys in the girls' bathroom. Kylie, whoa, Kylie. Well, Michael Devine was new at the folk. He smacked that.
Hello, 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 hello. Welcome to another exciting adventure of Hollywood and Devine. I'm your host, Michael Devine, and I must say I'm very excited because this is our no-frills, Halloween, semi-junk-free, Stephen J. Silverman-free show, and I'm very happy that it is. Check out my new hairdo. Got a cut. Looks nice. I'd like to introduce you today to someone who's taking the place of Stephen J. Silverman. He is our guest gatekeeper, and let me introduce you to Michael Silverman, Stephen's brother.
Well, Mr. Doing, Michael? Michael Devine, it's a pleasure to be here.
And
I am ecstatic to join you.
It shows.
And being able to appear on the show.
Yeah.
I can't wait to get started here.
Well, that's just quite very kind of you to express such words to me at this time.
Oh, you're so very welcome.
Because you think you're getting paid, but you're not. So where is your brother today?
It's the honor of just actually being here and helping you out.
Where's your brother today?
I think he's working today.
He's either
but
working
he's
or
un- he's dead. No, he's not dead. He's just unable to appear. He's indisposed.
Okay. All right. Well, let me explain to you who's on our show today. I'm very honored to have the Andy Kaufman of entertainment here today. It's the amazing Jerry Solomon, who's also known as Jerry Knight of Fairfax. And we're very excited to have him today. Also,
today,
every Halloween show should have a black cat, but today we have on our show today the beloved Oprah Bear. And the Oprah Bear is going to only be on this show today because we're not going to have a Friends episode when, remember when the chimpanzee was on the show and it became the whole show?
Oh, it
and
did.
And killed it off?
Oh, no.
So, beloved Oprah Bear here is only going to be on the show once today. That's it. Then we're getting rid of beloved Oprah Bear. Now, let's get on to some business here. Take a guess who I am today for Halloween.
You're the pajama man.
Well, no, close. No, I'm Burt Reynolds when he was 30 years old.
Burt Reynolds?
Yes.
You're not going to be BJ and the Bear, are you?
No, but I think Burt Reynolds needs to be back in movies, doesn't he?
What was that movie he was doing where he was racing around town?
I don't know.
Where he was in those races?
Oh, the cannonball movies?
The cannonball movies, that's it. I was thinking of BJ.
Then there was that Lonnie tragedy.
I was
anyway,
thinking of BJ and the Bear.
Right, right. Okay, Bear today, gone tomorrow. Anyway, also on today's show, our very scary silent movie, Michael Devine's The Smell of Death and Black Licorice. It stars Todd Schwartz, Dean Cloud, Viga Shade, and Neil Rosen. And it's a very suspenseful, lunatic kind of a
really?
Yes.
Really?
Yes, really.
Oh, my, I can't wait to see that. I wonder if they're going to have organ music with that.
Organ you think music they'll have or the orgasms.
You'll think they'll have the big Wurlitzer organ playing
I
in the background.
It's not in the budget.
We should definitely arrange to have that. Maybe in your next movie that you show.
Yes, possibly. Mm-hmm. Anyway, we like to dedicate each show, if you've watched our show before, we dedicate it to someone very special. And I'd like to dedicate...
Who is it today?
Oh, well, I'll get right on it.
Okay.
Today it is Rodri Rodriguez. She is the talented
Yay for Rodri.
Talk show host and president of Mariachi USA. This is me and Rodri. And why do we like her? Because she's Marie Osmond with Honkers.
Wow.
She's Marie Osmond with
She's
honkers.
Got real honkers.
She's got honkers. And that's where we like Rodri. Because she's got honkers. I need a new talker.
Yeah, it does sound
so
pretty weak.
We're very glad that Rodri is our special dedicated person today. Now, let me go through my notes here. I'm very excited this year because I'm national spokesman for Hernia Prevention and Awareness Month. Yes, and in December is when we, you know, is the month where people are doing heavy lifting and stuff like that.
Be careful out there.
I know. Christmas trees and Hanukkah bushes.
Bend with the knees, exactly, and not with the back.
Exactly. Very good.
You're quite welcome.
Now I'm going to get a little emotional here today because I don't like to talk about my problems, but I was a tragic sufferer of a hernia.
Oh, you were.
Several years ago.
It's,
I'm going to get emotional.
It's here. Okay. It's okay. Quite all right. Shall I hold your hand for you?
No,
it's
get quite back. No. Let's get a little emotional. You don't know the pain and suffering of a hernia. You're standing in front of a mirror naked. On the right side, you have a round, small testicle. And on the left side, bam, you have a testicle the size of a bowling ball, the size of an ostrich egg, the size of a beach ball. And if you're a black man, hell, it's the size of a watermelon, the size of a basketball, the size of a 1969 Ultra Sheen Afro. It's horrible.
Oh,
have you ever stopped to think what a hernia does for your life? It's horrible.
Doesn't it make you walk funny?
Yes. And it punches out the holes of your pants. Anyway.
It hurts.
Yes, hernias hurt. A couple years ago, I wanted to be the Easter Bunny for Halloween. Damn, I have my own damn Easter egg, for God's sakes. Anyway, please support Hernia Awareness and Prevention Month by wearing a smiling Sammy Scrotum safety pin, like so. And you are, when you wear Sammy, you are fighting hernias, because we're trying to wipe out hernias in your lifetime. You know, hernias have been around for a long time. So please wear a smiling Sammy scrotum safety pin. And hey dudes, if you got a lump in your scrotum, don't stand there playing with yourself. Get it checked out, get it fixed, because hernias will ruin your life.
Yes, they will.
Remember December, that's our slogan.
Get it checked.
National Hernia Awareness and Prevention Month. And that
and what else do we have on our agenda?
Okay, I think we're going to be showing our movie. I think we're ready for the movie.
We're ready for the movie.
Yeah, I think so.
Are you sure? Can you give us a little brief description of what this movie is actually going to be about?
Well, it's kind of psycho, kind of, you know. Well, let's just run the movie. It's Michael Devine's The Smell of Death and Black Licorice, excuse me. So I guess we can roll it. We can roll it, boys. There we go.
Oh, look, Geppetto. Where is this little monkey in the organ grinder?
When you're a stranger, faces look ugly. When you're alone, women seem wicked. When you're unwanted, streets aren't even. When you're down, when you're strange, faces come out of the rain. When you're strange,
I don't know.
You don't know. She must be the happy-go-lucky lady, isn't she?
When you're strange,
look at this guy in the
street. When you're strange,
Nothing strange around here, Mike.
Hello? Hello?
There's
Mama. Whoa, Mama.
Faces come out of the rain.
Hey, that almost looks like Jerry.
You're strange.
There's Mama again.
No one remembers your name. When you're strange.
Oh, look. Look. Look, there she is. Bouncing up. More honkers. I guess they're taking her for a walk, or she's taking them for a walk, ain't she?
Yeah.
Oh, look, they finished with their Jiffy Pop. Boy, they're really going at it. I feel sorry for the guy with the straitjacket.
When you're strange, faces come out of the rain.
Boy,
when
talk about a feeding
strange,
frenzy.
No one knows your name. when you're strange.
Oh, well.
When you're strange. When you're strange.
This is our daily food portion. We only get fed once a day. Do we have any water for you?
I give all the foreigners a break.
No, thank you.
Where's their water? You don't even give them water.
Indeed.
Oh, wow. Divine. What a beautiful part of the country.
All right. Everybody getting a little chance tonight to warm up the mic and sing to us. So now we're going to invite up for the first time, Rodney.
Oh, did you
come on up, Rodney.
They're all punch drunk.
Another
huh?
good song here.
Talk about a perfect advertisement for Coca-Cola.
Rodney.
I hope they at least.
First
oh, mama.
Woohoo. So put your hands together. Come on. Make
a... I believe she's still alive.
Nah. How many years ago was this made?
10.
Hey, let's go swimming.
This is the choreography.
Oh, really? Yeah, this is great. Are they gonna do the water water aerobics? Yeah.
Look at some of them.
Push her in. Push her in. Oh, mama. Because you look so look, dude, mama looks so sexy in that bathing suit, doesn't she? Yeah. That's their medicine, huh? Oh, mama.
Oh, no.
Who are they going to shoot? No! No! Oh no!
They shot the doctor. Yeah.
Somebody get a doctor for the doctor. Oh, mama!
My trigger, now he's dead. Mama!
Is that Mama Teresa?
No, Sister Svetlana.
Oh, Sister Svetlana. What are we gonna do? What, are you gonna push him in the pool?
Hope floats.
Too late.
Try to get Sandra Bullock.
Oh, mama.
She didn't like the
shivers down my spine.
She was going to play the nun.
Aching all the time.
It's been saved.
Goodbye, everybody. Got to go. Gotta leave all behind and face the truth.
Oh no, the graffiti on the wall.
Mama.
All right, way to go. What a show.
Wonderful.
And honkers for that bouncing lady.
That's right. Now, what you did realize, the reason the doctor was killed in this movie was, you see, the crazy psycho guy.
Yeah.
He had licorice in a bowl, and he told the doctor never to go in there and take the licorice. He warned him. He warned him on numerous occasions.
Oh.
And finally he
that was his licorice.
Killed him. It was his licorice.
It was his medicine.
Exactly.
Oh,
so that
no.
that is the smell of death in black licorice. Now I think it's time we have our guest.
Our special honored guest.
The amazing Jerry Solomon. He's the Andy Kaufman of karaoke.
Oh, the amazing.
Exactly.
The amazing
so
Jerry Solomon.
When we come back or when we get ready or when it's
in
time.
Just a moment, we'll be right back.
Yes,
and
Jerry
we will
Solomon.
Actually introduce Jerry Solomon to our wonderful show here of Hollywood and Devine.
Well, thank you. Let's go to Jerry.
They laughed at me, made mockery of me as I lay there in the arena. But now, alas, I have returned.
turn. On. Return.
We're back, and it really makes me very emotional to see that we have a legend here on my show, and the amazing Jerry Solomon is sitting right beside me. Jerry Solomon, that was wonderful, man. That was wonderful. I'm not worthy, man. I'm not worthy.
It was a heck of a performance. You need not just an Emmy, but the Academy Award of all performances.
That was wonderful, Jerry. Not only do you need an Emmy, you need an enema. But not on this show. I guess we'll get right to the questioning. You got some questions?
So, Jerry, you want to make yourself a little more comfortable? How about taking off your helmet? There you go. What's wrong, Jerry? You're afraid of...
Well, I don't usually like to be seen in public, but...
Not to worry, Jerry. These are your people, right? The people
the fans,
that
the fans want to see your face, Jerry.
The people you fight for, Jerry.
You fight for justice, don't you, Jerry? You fight to be famous, don't you, Jerry? The fans need to see your face, Jerry. I beg of you, please. Expose yourself to your adoring fans. This is a legend here today, folks.
Yes, it is.
And I'm very proud to have him on my show. And I think we have a few questions we want to ask Jerry before.
I think we do.
Shoot.
Jerry, you have quite an outfit here.
Oh, thank you.
How long have you lived in California?
Lived in California since I've been born. But I lived in various cities or parts of cities. I was born in San Diego near the zoo.
Oh. At the zoo?
No.
Near the
not,
zoo?
Not in the zoo. Look.
Your parents were having sex at the zoo?
No, I was born in near the zoo.
Oh. You're part of
San Diego.
Did you work at the zoo?
No, I never worked at the zoo. Uh-huh. Although I was thinking of applying for a job there where they have me as one of the humans in... What do you call a human being? What's that word you call a human being?
Homo erectus?
Homo sapien?
That's it. Homo sapien.
I think of them having me in a display me as a representative of the Homo sapiens.
Homo sapien.
Homo sapien species.
Oh. Are you a thespian too?
What does that mean?
Well, not lesbian, thespian.
What does thespian mean? I heard of it. I think that's my class I think that's my class name. High school reunion name.
Yeah.
What does it mean? I don't even know what it means.
Thespians are the people who actually go out and do the drama classes.
Exactly.
And it's the group of kids that are usually in the drama class.
Exactly.
Oh.
In school.
Oh,
so they're known as the thespians.
I was
the actors and actresses of...
I was in drama class at Belmont High School.
Oh, you went to Belmont.
Well, I went to Hamilton and Belmont, and then they had me in the scene carrying a dead body, and then I dropped it.
Oh, Jerry, hold on. I have everybody that comes on my show, their guests, they have to color on my show. So, let me get the coloring book out here for you. Okay.
And you don't mind if we ask you a few questions while you'll sit here and color?
Yeah, pick any color.
What's this for?
It's for therapy.
It's part of the program.
It's part of the program. Just color.
Yeah, just go ahead and color.
Yeah. It shows us kind of where you're coming from or where you're going. Yeah. Oh, that's pretty. Yeah,
you should use it.
Yeah.
I could change colors.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
You got a whole
box.
You can do anything on my show. Yeah, that's pretty. Wow, you're going out of the lines. That says a lot about your personality. Can we show the camera?
I don't know. I haven't driven.
The legend has done some coloring.
I haven't.
Check this out. Isn't that wonderful?
I haven't drawn in a few decades.
Oh, okay.
I used to draw or do.
Now, Jerry, did you run for office?
Yeah. Oh, where's my book that showed the tally sheet?
Oh, you left your tally sheet at home.
No, it's.
Anyway, Jerry ran for office against Pete Wilson.
I ran for governor in 1990. Oh, I have the tally sheet. Oh, nuts.
We'll get it out to the fans.
We'll pull it up in a few minutes.
Yeah, so how many votes did you get, Jerry?
No, I got 12 votes.
And were they all family members?
It was family members, friends.
Seems like it was a very emotional experience for you.
Yeah, I ran in 1990 as governor of California.
Oh, that's nice.
And Pete Wilson beat me by about 3 million votes.
Oh, that awesome.
Oh, poor Pete.
I had to get signatures to qualify,
right,
to be certified, and one person kept running from me. I had to literally chase this one person, sort of so-called buddy of mine, from me.
It was only one person.
To get his signature. Running for all week, he was running from me at my old job. Then finally, at the end of the week, he signs a thing. Mm-hmm. Finally, he signs. I thought, oh, thanks a lot, as I said. Thanks a lot. And he's walking away. I said, thanks a lot, sucker.
That's nice. That's very nice. Well, Jerry, I understand you're a member of the Jewish community. You're Jewish, are you?
Yeah.
And I understand that.
On the night of Fairfax.
Exactly, the night of Fairfax. That you have never been circumcised?
What? What are you talking about?
I heard that you were never circumcised, so Michael is an expert here on circumcision.
How could you say?
I think we should have this alligator do it.
We got a knife?
Excuse me.
We need ratings for this show, Jerry.
Me, I don't need to be circumcised. I could show you. You're completely wrong.
You got a towel?
No, I don't need to be circumcised.
Oh, you have been circumcised.
I have been circumcised.
Oh, all right.
You don't believe me?
No, Jerry, no.
You don't believe me? I wasn't.
All right, we believe you, Jerry.
Sit down.
I just heard this rumor. I don't know. Mike specializes in circumcisions. He's Jewish, so just have a seat, Jerry. Chill out.
You know. Don't believe me, I could show you.
No, that's quite all right.
No, that's
you want to be on the air for a while.
I don't know.
He's got another question for you.
So do you know what a spindle is?
What does that mean?
You know what a spindle is?
I don't know what that is.
You don't know what a spindle is?
No.
So if your spindle was loose, you wouldn't know where to look, right?
Yeah. You don't know what a spindle is?
Being a man of iron, being a man of iron and fighting and steel, you don't
Superman.
Know what a spindle is?
I'm not sure what I've heard of it, but I'm not sure what it means.
You don't actually use a rod or a shaft to actually perform.
Now, Jerry, are you sure you have been circumcised, really?
No.
You have?
The last time I took a shower.
All right. Because they say two circumcisions are better than one. He specializes in that.
Don't forget about your
the last time I took a shower, you know what I mean? In fact, that's the only time I take my clothes off is when I take a shower, because I'm currently a celibate.
Oh,
you are, huh?
Oh,
but you said you told us.
Is that like a vegetarian? No, I don't know. I don't know. Anyway, how many minutes do we got? Do you have the watch? Are we getting close? Oh, three. Well, I'd like to thank my guests today, Jerry Solomon and Michael Silverman. And I have a final thought for the show. Now, my final thought is, whenever you're traveling in a car,
Mr. Gomez,
or, you know, you're going near or far, do not hold your doo-doo. Because if you hold your doo-doo, you might get doo-doo on you. So, use a bathroom if you have to. I'd like to thank Jerry again. And Mike Silverman.
You're very, very welcome. It's my pleasure.
It was wonderful having you on our show.
What about Mr. Gomez?
Mr. Gomez. Oh, yes. And please remember, Gomez is coming.
You're covering up his picture. Please.
Gomez is coming.
Gomez is coming. Is coming.
Remember.
Watch out for Mr. Gomez.
Now, everybody, thanks. Have a good night.
And have a wonderful evening. We would like to wish all of you sweet dreams, and we would like to thank you, our listening audience, for being a part of Hollywood and Devine.
Hey, hello. Hey, if you liked our show, you want to call us, you want to give us some sort of, letter, give us a call. The information is at the end of the show. We want to hear from you. If you like the show, call us. If you didn't like the show, we don't want to hear from you, but we'll call you. Thank you.
I'm talking dope. I'm smoking, talking, smoking. I'm talking dope. I'm smoking dope. I'm talking, smoking, talking. I'm smoking dope. I'm talking dope. I'm smoking, talking, smoking. I'm talking dope. You should have been there. She really got it. You should have been there. No one could stop it. Connie's gonna get you smoking dope with black boys in the girls' bathroom, Connie. Whoa, Connie. Connie's gonna get you smoking dope with black boys in the girls' bathroom, Connie. Whoa, Connie. Well, Michael Devine was new at the folk. He smacked dab into the mess. As Allison Cutler stood sucking on coke, trying to explain her best. You see, Francine got fired and so did Renee. They were playing around. They were the fools on April 1st, yelling fire in the theater throughout. You should have been there. She really got it. You should have been there. No one could stop it. Connie's gonna get you smoking dope with black boys in the girls' bathroom, Connie. Whoa, Connie. Connie's gonna get you smoking dope with black boys in the girls' bathroom, Connie. Whoa, Connie. Well, Connie's a cashier. She came screaming downstairs and saw Larry Love at the door. Ran at a rave, cause Francine was engaged in some doobie jamming on the second floor. Larry, call the police. Call the police. Call the police. Larry, call the police. She's up there smoking. She's up there talking. Now call me a liar. Was she not fired? Larry, call the police. Call the police. Call the police.